Hey, it's Matthew Valley Frontiersman sports editor Jeremiah Bartz, and here are my top 10 stories in 2017 in the world of Valley Prep Sports. Teeing off with number 10, the Colony Knights hockey team makes school history. Colony finished third in the 4A state hockey tournament with a 4-3 overtime win over Eagle River. It was the first top three finish for the program. At number 9, Ryan Engebretson hits a milestone. The Wasilla head coach in boys basketball reached 200 career victories in February. It took only 10 years for Engebretson to hit the mark. And number 8, some school history for Reddington football. 2017 was a year of firsts for the third-year program. First win, first road win, first conference win, first home win. This came after Reddington combined to start 0-12 in its first 2 years. At number 7, a baseball four-peat. The Wasilla Warriors earned their fourth straight South Central Conference title. The Warriors continued the impressive streak with a 15-5 win over rival Colony in the region title game. And number 6, more Wasilla sports. The Warrior girls earned their second straight state title. This one came with a 51-34 victory over Diamond. It was one of the best game plans put together by a coaching staff in a game that I personally witnessed in any sport in 2017, and the Warrior girls executed it to perfection. At number 5, I've got a list of 3 Valley athletes for you. Tanner Shackle, Jarek Schultz, and Eve Stevens each had the opportunity to make their commitment to play at the next level each year. Dozens of Valley athletes earn their opportunity to compete at the next level. While I congratulate all, I selected 3 who stand out in my mind. Former Wasilla hockey standout Tanner Shackle and a pair of Colony seniors, Jarek Schultz and Eve Stevens. Shackle currently skates for the Fairbanks Ice Dogs, the Junior A North American Hockey League, announced that he'll play at UAA and skate at the D1 level. Schultz, a Colony football standout, signed with Division I Northern Arizona and will play football. Stevens, a Colony volleyball star, will also go to UAA, and she's going to play D2 volleyball for the Seawolves. At number 4, Seal Dunleavy, the former Wasilla High School track and field standout, made Alaska history with her fourth straight state title in the girls' long jump. She's the first boy or girl in Alaska history to get the four-peat. She also holds the state record in the event. And at number 3, I had never seen a JV athlete earn a region MVP honor until this year. Allison Vantel was named the Region 3 Girls MVP in cross-country running. She's a Matsu Career and Tech student, a junior. After a couple of years at Houston High School with the Hawks running team, she opted to go to Wasilla High and run with the Warriors. But because of the transfer, she was not able to compete at the varsity level due to ASAA rules. But that didn't stop her. Van Pelt posted the third fastest time in the state in 2017. And if she ran in the region varsity race, she would have been an individual champion. And at number 2, Jacob Butcher and Nolan Monahan. It's typical to see a local kid play for the Matsu Miners, but usually they don't see a ton of playing time. This year was different. Monahan, a former Wasilla standout, and Butcher, a former Colony standout, both helped the Matsu Miners win an Alaska Baseball League title. Both pitched really well, worked big innings, and scored some key victories on the mound for the Miners. And now, my top story from 2017. Rod Christensen becomes the all-time leader in career victories in Alaska prep football history. The longtime Palmer High School head coach tied the late, great Buck Nystrom at 150 with a win over Eagle River and then broke the career record with a victory at Kenai. Coach C, who led Palmer to its second straight state title game in 2017, now has 153 career wins. So that does it. Those are my top 10 Valley sports stories from 2017. Let's see what 2018 has for us. Thanks for reading. I'm Jeremiah Bartz.